There was once an old king who had a daughter called Beryl, who was more beautiful than all the beautiful princesses in all the fairy tales ever. But Beryl was so spoilt and conceited, she was completely unbearable. So the king decided she should get married, so she could go and live in someone else's house and leave him in peace. And he went to speak to her while she was lounging around in her emerald swimming pool that was filled with delicious lemonade. Swim, swim. Swim, swim. Hello, Beryl, dear. Shut up, go away. Now, that's not very polite, is it, Beryl? So what? I'm a princess. I can do what I like. Well, Beryl, you'll like this idea. I've decided that you should get married. So tomorrow, all the royal and rich young men in the world are coming for you to choose from. Oh, no, no way, said Beryl. Get lost. Now listen, said the king. They're already invited, so that is that. Said Beryl, because she wasn't the nice sort of princess at all. And the next day, Beryl walked past the long row of kings, grand dukes, princes, earls, barons, rich merchants, and a bus conductor who was pretending to be important. Ding, ding. I know Lord Litchfield, you know. And Beryl was awful. Oh, look at him! He's such a big nose, you'd think he was an elephant. Oh, no, that was too thin. He'd slip down the plug hole. And that was too small. I'd trip over him and ruin my hairdo. He's too pale. He looks like he's dead. No, eyes too small. No, eyes too big. No eyes at all. Oh, no, he's standing the wrong way around. And that was too ugly. He'd crack all the mirrors. And as she said all these cruel things, she laughed and laughed. But then she came to one whose chin was a bit crooked. Oh, no, what a scream! He looks like one of those birds from the garden with the wiggly beaks. What do you call them? Thrushes. Yes, he looks like a thrush. That's what I'll call him. King Thrushbeard. Yes, everyone call him that from now on. Go on. Mr. King Thrushbeard. It'll serve him right for being so stupid looking. Oh, let me sit down. I'm going to pass out. I'm laughing so much. Oh, dear.
How can you be so cruel? Said King Thrushbeard. I love you, Beryl.
Oh, don't be daft. Get out of it, said Beryl. And she threw one of the servants at him. Beryl's father was really angry with her. That is it. I have had enough. You can marry the next beggar that comes to the door. And at that very moment, they heard, Let the moonlight. And there was a poor beggar singing at the door. Oh, let him come in, the king said. I like a bit of music. And the beggar came in wearing dirty, raggedy clothes and sang before the old king and Princess Beryl. Thank you very much. When he had finished, the old king said, Your song has pleased me so much, I'll give you my daughter Beryl here to be your wife. Beryl screamed and stamped her feet. That is enough, said the king. I said I'd give you to the first beggar who came along, and I meant it. Off you go. And the beggar took Beryl's hand in his very dirty hand and led her out of the palace. She had to walk with him for miles and miles on foot. I'm not used to this, she said. I go everywhere by golden carriage. Get me a carriage. I don't like carriage, said the beggar, and they carried on foot. Walked past beautiful forests and towns full of happy, smiling people. And every time Beryl asked, How beautiful, who does this belong to? The beggar would say, It belongs to King Thrushbeard. If you'd have married him, it would have been yours. And Beryl replied, Oh, no. Why didn't I marry King Thrushbeard? What's the matter? Aren't I good enough for you, darling? Well, of course you're not, you stinking, raggedy lump of... Blech. But I'm stuck with you, aren't I? Then they walked past a very smelly drain. Oh, yuck! A very smelly drain, said Beryl. Let's walk past quickly.
What are you talking about? That's my house, said the beggar.
Don't be stupid. Who lives in a drain?
We do, darling.
Not likely, said Beryl. But the beggar pulled her in.
Come on, me lovely sweetness. I'll show you around. That's the corner. That's the other corner. That's the slime, and that's about it.
Well, the beggar tried to please her by cooking her a meal of his very best food. Rats' heads and bird droppings.
Here you are. I hope you like it, dear.
Yuck, said Beryl, and poured it over his head.
Oh, dear. Well, that was the last of the fresh food. I'll beg her out begging. Bye-bye, my angel.
And off he went. And Beryl lay in the drain all day, screaming and breaking things and being starving hungry. But that evening, the beggar came home bursting with excitement.
Guess what I found, my darling?
Drop dead.
Ha ha, good gag. It's the most beautiful thing I've ever found, and I want you to have it, because I love you so much.
And he handed her a withered up red rose in a bit of silver paper. Beryl hit him over the head with it. It's revolting. You're revolting. I hate you. I want some cake. The poor beggar was nearly in tears. But he said,
hey, hang on. I know where you might get some cake, my darling. Why don't you go and work at the king's palace as a kitchen maid? Maybe you could bite off a little corner of a cake while no one's looking.
Oh, this is ridiculous, said Beryl. I used to have a whole bedroom made of cake. But she went to the palace anyway, because she was starving. When Beryl got to the palace, the cook hit her with a rolling pin and said, what do you want, beggar woman? A job, please, near the cakes. Oh, all right then. I'm taking on lots of extra servants today because the king's having a huge party and he's getting married today. So come on in, just for today, and wipe your feet and wipe your nose. In fact, wipe all of you. You're disgusting. You look as if you've been down a drain. Well, come on then, get working. Well, in each pocket of her dress, Beryl fastened a glass jar, and she slipped little scraps and leftovers of food into the jars, so that she could have a little feast when her work was finished. And in the evening, Beryl sneaked out of the kitchen when the cook wasn't looking and crept up the back staircase. She hid by the door to the king's ballroom and looked as his wedding guests started to arrive. Each one was more beautiful than the last, and they danced to splendid music, tripping about the floor in shoes made of diamonds and pearls. Well, it's no wonder they tripped. And they laughed, ha ha, and fluttered their fans and ate peach ice cream from rose petal plates. And Beryl's eyes filled slowly with tears. Oh dear, she sobbed to herself. If only I hadn't been such a horrible person, life would be so easy for me. And she thought about the rose that the poor beggar had given her and realized just how cruel she'd been. Poor thing. When I get back to the drain, I'm going to give him all the scraps I've collected in my jars to make it up to him. And then suddenly, da-da-da-da-da-da-da! And all at once, the king entered the ballroom on his own. And he walked straight past all the beautiful lady guests. Hello, hello, oh, he's gone. And he went straight over to where Beryl was hiding behind the door. And he took her hand and asked her to dance with him. Oh, oh no, said Beryl. Just look at the state of me. You can't dance with me. Then she looked at his face and realized with horror that it was King Thrushbeard. Oh, no, let me go, she shrieked. But he pulled her onto the dance floor. And as she started to dance, the glass jars fell out of her pockets and the greasy scraps and runny leftover soup spilled all over her feet. The people at the ball saw this and laughed until Beryl was so ashamed she'd rather have been 1,000 miles below the ground. But King Thrushbeard kept hold of her hand and said to her kindly, Bella Beryl, I am a king now, but I am also the beggar who's been living with you in the drain. Watch.
Hello, baby, it's me again!
See, I can do that. Because I love you so much, I disguised myself as a disgusting man. I had to do those things to stop you being so cruel to people. Beryl wept bitterly.
Oh, I know I was pretty horrible, but I'm not like that now.
Shh, 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 shh. I know you're not, said King Thrushbeard. Hey, I love you. You have such a beautiful eyes, such a beautiful name. You know what the Beryl means in Italian? It means wipe your nose on the carpet. Hey, but I still love you. And then the maids-in-waiting came and put the most splendid wedding dress on Beryl. And her father came with his whole court to see her get happily married to King Thrushbeard. And the wedding was the most wonderful the world had ever seen.